Hello, everyone, and welcome to Coffee with Me and Jesus. Today I want to talk about a little story in the book of Samuel. And it's about how Samuel came to be, but I'm not going to focus on Samuel. I want to talk about the priest Eli. Eli was a very old priest, and his two sons did horrible things in the sight of God. They were unfair with the offerings and the sacrifices that people brought into the temple, and they also had sexual activity with women at the gates. Well, Eli had heard of the horrible evil his sons were doing. And he had warned his sons, if a man sins against another man, God can defend him. But if a man sins against God, who can defend him? Now, this is where I want to stop at this story, because that particular scripture just jumped out at me and how true it is. See, we as human beings, God will forgive us of our deeds. But when we knowingly, see, Eli's two sons, they knowingly did things against God. It wasn't against their people, the people, it was against God, because God had mandated a certain role of the priesthood. They had to be observant and very careful of certain things. Well, the two sons chose not to be obedient to God. And that's why this scripture really jumped out at me. Listen to it again. If a man sins against God, who can defend him? However, if a man sins against another man, God can forgive them. See, God can forgive us of our wrongdoings to one another. But when we knowingly do something that we know that God has said, don't do that, then there is a price to pay, because in the end of the story, the whole lineage of priesthood was stripped away from Levi. And it was going to be, God had sent a prophet to Eli to tell him, when your two sons are dead, then you'll know that the prophecy has been fulfilled. So that whole line got stripped out of the priesthood. Now think about that. When we knowingly do something that we know God said, don't do that, and we go ahead and do that. See, this is where the body needs to be held to a higher level of accountability. And we are not speaking and preaching on these things. See, we all know the Ten Commandments. That's a pretty basic thing. Don't steal, don't kill, don't lie. Only one God, bow down before no other idols, no false idols, love the Lord God first. You know, 10 rules. We all know those. Now, when we break those rules, we're not breaking them to man. We're not breaking those. We are breaking them to God. And it trickles down through the generations of our family. And that's what people need to hear, and they need to listen, because God wiped out that whole line of priesthoods of Aaron because of Eli's sons. And Eli chose to turn a blind eye to it. He didn't do anything about it. He chose to turn a blind eye, and he lost his two sons in battle. And he himself, when he heard the news, it is recorded that he fell back in his chair, and because he was so heavy, his head hit and he died. And that was the end. That was the end of the priesthood of Eli. So see, you and I are the same. God has given us some rules. Now, when we know we break these rules, and they are simple rules, they are easy for us to understand, very easy. That's why I get so upset with this big ordeal of all the attention right now is spotlighted on Satan because of all of his sins. You know what? Everybody knows what sin is. Everybody knows. Now, I want that big old giant spotlight to be taken off of Satan and be put on God. And we need to hear as a body what God said. The Ten Commandments, see, they were taken out of the school. They were taken out of a lot of places that our young ones should have been taught. And are you teaching those to your children? Are you teaching the Ten Commandments to your children? Because if not, the judgment hand of God is going to come down hard on your children, on you and on your children and on your children till somebody stands up and says, we need to enforce and live according to what is written in the Ten Commandments. And these are not hard things to do. It's not hard to love the Lord God with all your might, all your mind, body, and soul. It's not hard to not worship another God. You just acknowledge God. It is not hard to it's not hard to not steal, to not kill, to not covet what your neighbors have. You know, we have these commandments, and it's not hard to do them. But if we don't enforce them, we are going to we don't want to hear this. The body does not want to hear about the judgment hand of God coming down. We want to hear that, oh, we live in His grace. His grace is sufficient for me. He loves me despite of the wrong that I'm doing to Him. He still loves me. Now, that's about a false doctrine and a false teaching if I ever heard one. So that is my message to you. And I believe it's right in Exodus 20. Let's go there. I wasn't prepared there to go there right now, but I think it's important. I think it's really important that we go to the Ten Commandments so that we know, okay, well, what, you don't even know what they are. Worship no God but me. Do not make for yourselves images of anything in heaven or earth or in the water or underneath the earth. Do not bow down to any idol or worship it. Because I am the Lord your God, and I tolerate no rivals. I bring punishment on those who hate me and on their descendants down to the third and fourth generation. But I show my love to 1,000 of generations of those who love me and obey my laws. Observe the Sabbath and keep it holy. Do not use my name for evil purposes, for I, the Lord your God, will punish anyone who misuses my name. On the Sabbath day, I skipped here. Observe the Sabbath day and keep it holy. You have 6 days in which to do your work, but the seventh day is a day of rest dedicated to me. On that day, no one is to work, neither you, nor your children, nor your slaves, your animals, nor the foreigners who live in your country. In 6 days, I, the Lord, made the earth, the sky, the seas, and everything in them. But on the seventh day, I rested. That is why I, the Lord, blessed the Sabbath and made it holy. Respect your father and mother so that you may live a long time in the land that I'm giving you. Do not commit murder. Do not commit adultery. Do not steal. Do not accuse anyone falsely. Do not desire another man's house. Do not desire his wife, his slaves, his cattle, his donkeys, or anything else he owns. That's all summed up in the law. Now, when you break these things, you are not breaking something against your brother. You're breaking against God, because you know why? Today you heard, and now you know better. And so now, guess what? Today begins the first day of accountability, and we all, myself included, are subject to what is written here in the story of Samuel, that but if a man sins against another man, God can defend him and forgive him and take it all into consideration when a man wrongs another man. But if a man sins against God, who can defend him? There's nobody that can defend you, because God is all in all. God is all. See, when you break these laws, now you have the understanding. You have heard with your ears. You have the understanding. You break these laws, you're breaking them unto God. and nobody can defend you. You will have to take the wrath of God and the judgment of God. So I know this is a harsh message, but you know what? Our God is coming back soon, and he's coming back for a holy people. And we need to gird up our belt of truth, which is the written word of God, and live it, read it, do it. Amen? So everyone, have a blessed day, and I'm going to see you tomorrow. And get in that word. Study that word, approve yourselves, and make yourselves worthy to walk out what God has called you to do. It's not a hard thing. Let's just get our eyes off of Satan and back on God and do what is right. It's just doing what's right, people. Do what's right. You know what's right? Now follow it out. Take one step, two step, three step. Choose. Make a choice. Okay, so have a blessed day. God be with everybody. Enjoy today, and we will talk tomorrow. Bye-bye now.